Hello beautiful people and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Floki. If you're here for the first time, if you're a returning subscriber, welcome home. Thank you so much. Thank you for coming back. Thank you for supporting our sister. Yo, guys, before I forget, are we loving the lippy? Is it giving? Huh? Face cut? So, I have been looking for the perfect brown lipstick. It has been a pain in the tush because I'm a fairly dark girl. And then you try get dark brown lipstick and it looks like mud on your lips. But Joanna K did a thing. This is Fearless. It's called Fearless if you go to Joanna K Cosmetics, which is a Kenyan brand. If you're Kenyan, support your own. So this is Fearless, an amazing lippy. I am living for it. I hope the camera is doing it justice because I really hope so. On today's agenda, I am taking stock of a video I did 3 years ago when I turned 30. So when I turned 30, I wrote a list of 10 things that I wanted for the next 10. So I called it top 10 for the next 10. I'm going to link it on this video if I can remember how to, but I will try, or in the description box below. And I sort of just put this down on paper. For me, it was very key that I write down what I was dreaming and then try to see how to get there. So we're going to take stock. Of course, my dreams are ambitious because I'm not mediocre. I was not made for, you know. Yeah, I'm laughing at myself because, bruh, life can humble you. Anywho, I think it just speaks to the power of dreaming big and believing in those dreams. And I wrote it down on paper because it's sort of like a commitment. And when you put things down on paper, it gives you the ability to try and map out steps towards getting there. No matter how far or out of reach they are, you sort of put things into perspective and see how to work towards getting there. So that was me 3 years ago, and today we're just gonna take stock. I had to listen back and see, you know, what was the mood, how was I, you know, feeling. And I was so enthusiastic. I think I need to be watching these videos over and over again so that I can remember the energy, because you know, life beats you. Unaenda kutafuta dream yako, you know, you're met with a hot slap with a hot slap that returns you to initangwaje factory settings, unarudi square uno. Anyway, I think I'm still dreaming. I think I'm still on that journey. So if you're interested in hearing this, please stick around and let's get right into it. Eh. So the first the first dream was home ownership. I want to own a home before I turn 40. There's so much importance in having a roof over your head. But let me tell you something. The real estate market in Nairobi. Ay, you guys. I don't know. Who are these people who buy 200 million Kenya shillings houses? Aje? Na pesa gani? Like, I am just so discouraged in a sense, because I really wanted to own a home. And you know, you think about, okay, what can I save? Even if it's a mortgage, you don't want to take a mortgage for 100 years if they exist, yeah? But like, how do I make it to where I want to go in this real estate market? If you find houses for sijui 8 million, I think there'll be 2 bedrooms. And you know, you're thinking of home ownership, you're thinking uko mbele. But I've decided, and I hope I can encourage people who are feeling like, hey, home ownership is just, yeah, I think just start small. Start with what you can. If it's a studio apartment or it's a 1 bedroom that you can afford, and then maybe you can convert it later for as a real estate investment. You can rent it out and it can bring you the moolah. You know what I'm saying? You become a real estate guru just like that. People, there are people who actually started like that, and you know, they buy a house, they flip it, or just start with what you can. So with this one, I do not yet own a home, unfortunately. But it's 3 years. I still got 7 more years to get there. I don't own a home. But the other thing I've also started thinking through is, you know, home ownership comes in different ways. You can buy a home, an apartment, or a home, a compound, whatever. Or you can build. So I've been looking at what does it take to build? And even if not in Nairobi, you know, what options do I have and are they viable? So I think I've just broadened my spectrum to think a little bit outside the box, not just home ownership. Ooh, I have the money, I want the home, but no, I'm thinking of what other ways are there, you know, to get me to realize this dream before I turn 40. Okay. The second thing on my list was to explore 10 African countries. Yani. This one has not moved much. I think I have 2 since I made that video. So 2 out of 10. Not doing so well. Because I think if you do the math, it should have been at least 1 country every year. But last year, my plans were thwarted by life. Right now, I'm currently in Watamu, where I came to celebrate my birthday. And honestly, my plan and my savings, what I was saving towards was Zanzibar, because I wanted to go to Zanzibar. But the economy, the dollar, now wow. The Kenya shilling is not performing. It's not performing. So now everything just feels super inflated. Everything just feels so expensive. I'm like, where will we go? Where will we go in this economy? And I'm still hopeful that this can become a reality. But as it is right now, the way my account is set up, we are struggling. But a girl can dream. A girl can dream. Maybe a time will come out between 3 countries in a year. And when I said explore, I meant, you know, I don't want to transit. I don't want to go for work and be stuck at a hotel conference. And then, no, I really just want to go somewhere and immerse myself for a week or a couple of days and just enjoy the country. Because I feel like we miss out on that a lot. Whenever people do work travel, or whenever, you know, if you're just on transit, it's like 24 hours and you're like, you're like a panya trying to steal food. Like, what can I do in one night? But I really just want to explore. So we are 2 out of 10. It's a poor performance, but I'll pull up my socks, all right, by the help of the Holy Ghost, by the help of the economy, and by the help of my hard work. Hallelujah. Can I get an amen? The number 3 thing on my list, guy, this list is discouraging. Was to own my dream car. Kai. Oh God. This one went to the drain. It went to the drain. Why? So I'll explain. My dream car was a BMW X1, and I wanted to own that car in this period of my life, you know, like in the now. I drive an old school Subaru Legacy. I am that girl. Safari Rally, babe. What is 140 kilometers? What is 160? Anyway, I am that babe. I drive a Subaru. And it's a good car. It moves me from one point to the other. It's actually an amazing car. Honestly, I have thought about it. Even my dad says, oh, your car doesn't look ladylike. But really, having that car really made this not a priority, because why am I buying the X1 again? And then the X1 is just, you know, it's a lovely car. It's a strong car. But I'm just like, kitoka legacy usinunue tena gari ndogo. Do you know what I mean? I don't know if it makes sense, but I spoke myself out of it and I was just like, you move on to the next one. So my dream car is my second dream car, which is a Land Rover Defender, alafu Mercedes G-Wagon. Okay, so the X1, I feel like I have gone past that, which is unfortunate, or is it? No, I think it just speaks to the power. I think I was very logical, because you know, you can just also chase dreams for the sake, or chase dreams because it was your dream. But does it make sense? Does it make economic sense? Number one, is it even logical? So once I get that car, what happens to what I currently have, which is serving me well and is, it's a beautiful, amazing car, and all I have to do at the moment is just spend money maintaining it. So I don't know, it just didn't feel like a worthy investment at the time. So right now I'm honestly working towards my Defender. Pray for me, guys. Pray for me because the prices, hey, that car is not cheap, man. But God day, we dream, we keep dreaming. Okay, I hope at the end of 10 years, people don't look at me like, yeah, you see, dreams are just dreams, they don't come true. Mine, you'll wish you dreamt with me, okay? The number four dream I had for the next 10 was to start a family of my own, guy. But I had a disclaimer. I said, it's not entirely dependent on me, okay? So, start a family of my own. This is a work in progress. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I am still very single. I am still desirous of having kids. And guys, to be candid, I have thought about adoption as an option, because I want a kid, you know, and whenever I start talking about this, my mom is just like, "Hey, apana utapata tu wako." So, my guy, my husband, wherever you are, we need to start this family. I can't start this family alone. So, number four is also still pending. Okay, guys, I feel, yeah, that's where we're at. But the desire is still there, so it's still on my list. It's not dropped. It's just not happened yet. To start a family, to get married, to have kids. I still want that, okay? Okay. All right, number five was career growth. And praise the Lord, because this one, God day, I have grown leaps and bounds in my career. So I changed jobs between 2020 and now. I have switched jobs to a better job, and a better job can be in so many aspects. There's elements of, if you look at just the money, you might not think it's a better job, but there's better job in terms of environment, better job in terms of, you know, the scope of work, what it allows you to do, and stuff like that. So I switched jobs, and I have been blessed to have, you know, assimilated, because I also had a fear of switching jobs. But I remembered that I had prayed for, you know, just growth in my career and just opportunities. And the opportunity came up. I thank God that this is one of the things that is going really well for me. And I have managed to grow in my career, and it's just been amazing. Wait, let me see. Oh yeah, let me not mention the what I'm studying, because it's actually my number seven. So number five was career growth, and I thank God that God has enabled me to have that. You know, growth comes in different forms, and if you decide to just look at the money, you might think you're not growing. But like, there's so many aspects to growth. What a job allows you to do, the free time a job accords you, you know, the ability to have a work-life balance, just growth, the scope of work that you're able to do. So yeah, it's been a good ride, and I really thank God for that. Number six was to become a dollar millionaire. Hallelujah. I'm a dreamer. If you don't dream it, if you don't dream it, you do not even give it the ability to manifest. So, next question. Let's just say I'm not there yet, but I'm getting there. I'm getting there. I have the faith and I have the ability. I have the brains. I have the, you know, the manpower, and I have God in my corner. So, getting there. The seventh one was to get a second degree. Now, for this one, I wanted to get a second degree in something, you know, not necessarily academic. Okay, all degrees are academic. Or maybe not, I don't know. I wanted a degree in, you know, something that is not necessarily along my career path. Event planning or, I don't know, interior design, floral, things that I actually enjoy. Like hobbies that could grow into something. But as I was just scouting for degrees, I came across this one that really sparked my interest, a degree in sustainable development. And your girl decided to enroll for her second master's degree, which is an MSc in sustainable development from the best university in development studies. Guess it. University of Sussex. So this one came true. Maybe not how I had envisioned it, but it came through. This is number what of the ones that have come through? 1, 2. Hey, 2 out of 7. Okay, 2.5. Because African countries. Number 8 was to be in the top 40 under 40 Forbes list. Now, I was trying to do my research on the kind of people who make it to the Forbes list. I have questions, but I'm still researching, and I know God will give me that eureka moment of ping. Yeah, so this is still not happening. The tweet is still pinned on my Twitter account because I want to be on that list. The how, I don't know, but between now and 40, Baba God, 7 years. This is our 7-year plan. Can happen anytime. Surprise me, yoga. The 9th thing was to be involved more in kingdom business. Now, for this one, I want to believe that I have grown leaps and bounds spiritually. God has just been good. And God has been working on me. Do you know, this season of isolation or solitude or whatever you're gonna call it has just been so pertinent in ensuring my spirituality is aligned and that I'm connected to my source. And my source is God the Father, yeah? So, I think this one, it's still a work in progress. You know, every day you grow, and with spirituality, it just doesn't end. The part I struggle with is being like actively involved in kingdom business. You know, like working in church and stuff like that. I don't volunteer as it stands, and I don't know. I have tried. You know how you try to sneak in and find avenues, but honestly, I'm struggling. It's good to admit an area that you're struggling with. So I really am not involved in kingdom business like that, you know. Like I watch my parents, they host Bible studies, and they're always having some outreach somewhere. They go to mourn with people, like Mimi. The last and not least was to grow my YouTube channel. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. So the YouTube channel has not grown. It has not grown much. It has grown. Hasn't grown much. I think I just lacking motivation to show up as my true self, just lacking motivation to create videos and to do this, and my inconsistency is to blame. This is purely my fault, and it's definitely gonna change. So this one, I take all the blame for all of it. This is on me. it's on me. The other stuff needs me, and you know, not a little, but it needs the hand of the Lord, yeah, you know, to push it, to make it happen. But I have thought these things, I have written them down, and I believe it's possible. I believe I can get it done. I believe I can get there. So, grow YouTube channel. Imagine I'm failing on this simple assignment. I'll work on it. This year, nimeamua, going forward. Mutachoka na mimi. Mutaniona hadi mchoke. Translated, you will see me until you get tired. I will be here every Friday, like clockwork. Yeah? Looking forward, guys. I think that marks the end of my video. And wait, before I go, I just want to encourage someone. Guys, I wrote this list. And as you can see, all, if not, like most of them, if not all, are a work in progress. Even the degree, I haven't attained it. I'm still at it, yeah? So it's all a work in progress. And I think I want to speak to the importance of the process and allowing yourself to enjoy the process. A lot of us are so fixated on the end game, or you're also probably fixated on shoulda, coulda, wouldas, yeah? When what you have is your present. And you just need to think about, how do I get there, number one, but also to learn to enjoy the process, because it's not like pop, you know. I'm happy, I'm blessed, guys. I am living life, I am loving life. All these things are not a reality in my life. They seem like dreams, they seem so distant, but I am working on them. And every day you make a step closer, you know, you inch closer to your dream, you inch closer to making it a reality. So be encouraged, don't be afraid to dream. Manze, write those big dreams down. I think in a few previous videos ago, I was telling you guys how I used to dream big. I mean, I was that unstoppable dreamer. Somehow life hit me and I realized I stopped just dreaming like a child. And you know, I started rationalizing my dreams. I started, you know, thinking of what's possible, what's not, before don't allow that to be you. Yeah. Dream as big as you can, as impossible as it seems. Put it on paper. Pray about it. Start working towards it. And before you know it, tutakuwa tuna dance. You'll call us for, you know, your testimony dance. So thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you liked it, please click the like button, share with your friends, and kindly subscribe and hit that notification bell so that you know whenever I post. But tumesha sema ni Friday. Fridays with Floki. So on Fridays, we have a date. All right? See you on the next one. Ciao.